This is today's lesson. Two inscribed angles intercepting the same arc. Proof and examples. Let us prove this theorem. Two inscribed angles that intercept the same arc or congruent arcs are congruent. In this figure, angle ADC is an inscribed angle intercepting arc AC. Angle CBA is also an inscribed angle intercepting arc AC. The two angles are intercepting the same arc. According to this theorem, they are congruent. Let us prove this by using a two-column proof. For our given, we have inscribed angles, angle ADC and angle CBA. We are going to prove that angle ADC is congruent to angle CBA. In the first column, we are going to write the statements. In the second column, the corresponding reasons. The first statement is usually the given data. So for our first statement, we have inscribed angles, angle ADC and angle CBA. The reason is of course given. Next statement, the measure of angle ADC. This is the angle ADC is the equal to one half of the measure of arc AC. And the measure of angle CBA is the also equal to one up of the measure of arc AC. The reason, inscribed angle theorem. According to the inscribed angle theorem, the measure of an inscribed angle is equal to one up the measure of the intercepted arc. Next statement, the measure of angle ADC is equal to the measure of angle CBA. The reason, transitive property of equality. And for our last statement, we have angle ADC is congruent to angle CBA. The reason, angles are congruent if they have the same measure. Example number one. If the measure of angle B is equal to 40, what is the measure of angle D? Solution. Angle B intercepts arc AC. And angle D intercepts arc AC. Angle D and angle B are inscribed angles intercepting the same arc. According to the theorem we just proved, two inscribed angles that intercept the same arc or congruent arcs are congruent. Therefore, angle D is congruent to angle B. If angle D is congruent to angle B, then the measure of angle D is equal to the measure of angle B. But it is given that the measure of angle B is equal to 40. So we substitute 40 for measure of angle B. We get measure of angle D is equal to 40. Example number 2. If the measure of angle AEC is equal to 85 and the measure of arc BD is equal to 50, find letter A, the measure of angle ABC, and letter B, the measure of angle CDA. Solution. Step number 1, find the measure of arc AC. Chord AB and chord CD intersect in the interior of the circle. The measure of the angle formed by these two chords is equal to one half of the sum of the measures of the intercepted arcs. So we can say that the measure of angle AEC is equal to one half times the quantity measure of arc AC plus measure of arc BD. But the measure of angle AEC is equal to 85 and the measure of arc BD is equal to 50. So substitute 85 for measure of angle AEC and substitute 50 for measure of arc BD. So we have now 85 is equal to 1 half times the quantity measure of arc AC plus 50. Cross multiply. 85 times 2 is equal to 170. So this is now 170 is equal to measure of arc AC plus 50. Transpose 50 to the left side, change its sign from positive to negative. So we have now 170 minus 50 is equal to measure of arc AC. So the measure of arc AC is equal to 120. Step number 2. Find the measure of angle ABC. Angle ABC is an inscribed angle. According to the inscribed angle theorem, the measure of an inscribed angle is equal to one half the measure of the intercepted arc. The intercepted arc here is the arc AC. So, the measure of angle ABC is equal to one half of the measure of arc AC. But the measure of arc AC is equal to 120. So, substitute 120 for measure of arc AC. We have now measure of angle ABC is one half of 120. And 1 half of 120 is 60. So the measure of angle ABC is equal to 60. Angle CDA is also an inscribed angle. And again, according to the inscribed angle theorem, the measure of an inscribed angle is 1 half of the measure of the intercepted arc. The intercepted arc here is also arc AC with a measure of 120. So, 1 half of 120 is equal to 60. So, we can say that the measure of angle CDA is equal to 60.